Hello students and welcome back to BankExamsToday.com. So SEBI Grade A exam held today, the phase 1 of SEBI Grade A exam held today, right? I just checked the morning shift exam. So today I'm going to share the exam analysis of the security market, quantitative aptitude and reasoning ability. So these three sections I'm going to cover. So let's start. The exam was like not that difficult, except the reasoning section, which was little time consuming. That paper was time consuming. It was not difficult, but doing 200 questions within 120 minutes is a headache. So I would say the security market awareness was not difficult at all. Actually, I'm really happy that a lot of questions actually came from our course. That the security market awareness classes that I actually conducted myself, most of the questions were there from our course. And English was actually not that difficult. While there was a lack of traditional questions, there were closed test and all, but I would say the English was easy. It was really easy. And security market was easy and quantitative aptitude was, these three sections were easy. While reasoning ability and general awareness, I would say they were of difficulty level was at moderate level, right? The difficulty was at moderate level. These were, you can say, moderate level. It was moderate to hard. It was not actually hard. Moderate is the right word. So the ideal attempt according to me should be between 130 to 140, I would say, right? That should be the ideal attempt, because the security market awareness easily doable. If you have completed your syllabus, there were no, you know, you can say difficult questions at all. The questions were easy. Even in the English, if you're reading a newspaper every day, it was not that difficult at all. Quantitative aptitude, there was a trick in the quantitative aptitude. The question, the miscellaneous questions were little difficult, I would say. While data interpretation was very easy, I would say very easy DI. The DI was very, very easy. I mean, if I would have, you know, used such questions in my test series, you would have given me 1 star, because you would say, sir, the questions are actually really easy. Do you think such question will be there in the exam? But yes, DI was super easy. So let's move forward with the security markets. Obviously, I taught the subject, so I should start with the security markets. The questions were common. The limit for retail investors as per the SEBI ICDR, 2 lakh rupees. Then what is a listing agreement? Listing agreement is between a depository or a, you know, whoever it is, the a stock exchange and a listed entity. That is, the listing agreement is between. The time limit for certificate of deposit, and then surprisingly, that was a surprise for me, the foreign exchange currency exchangeable bonds. I know that we didn't do this thing in depth. I apologize for that. I was not sure about that, but that was a surprise factor in the whole exam, in the whole security market awareness, you know, section. There were 4 questions from foreign currency exchangeable bonds. The person who actually made the paper, he was too much interested in foreign currency exchangeable bonds. Then there was a simple question from ADR, a depository receipt traded in which exchange is known as ADR, obviously US. Then which of the following laws are related to security markets? SEBI Depository Act. So you need to select which one is not the law related to security markets. Then there was a question from which of the following is a function of depository. Various functions were mentioned, which is not a function. Then duties, which of the following is not a duty? Making a trading terminal is not a duty of a depository. This question was there. Then there were 3 questions from LODR. Really basic questions were there. One more important thing that I want to tell you students, even if you are preparing for the phase 2, basic questions were there. No technical questions, basics of everything was there. But the fact is that everything was there. All the topics mentioned on the official syllabus, everything was there, but just basic. So a lot of questions were there from Securities and Exchange Board of India Act 1992. A lot of questions were there. The history of Securities Act, the questions from there as well. And then who's the chairman of Finance Commission? There were two questions from Finance Commission. The second one I forgot. Which of the following are revenue expenditure, revenue income? There was taxes, there was income from investment and all, right? You need to find out which one is not. Really simple. Unpublished to price sensitive information. I did a proper lecture on that. So out of the previous, you know, all the questions were from our course. We covered everything in our course, but I admit that foreign currency exchangeable bonds, I didn't cover that properly. That was a surprise for me as well. These four questions were not from our course. Rest of the questions were, all the questions were from our course. So this is the one that I was really surprised. That surprised me. So the types of money market instruments, really simple. Which of the following is a money market or a money market instrument? Another question was there, which of the following instruments are issued by government? Then the powers of SAT, really simple. Minimum investment by anchor investor, right? The demutualization was there. Simple definition of YTM. So that was actually a topic of finance, but it came in that security market. So that was not a kind of surprise. But if you are already preparing for phase 2, that's really simple. The financial instrument issued by government. And this was a surprise again. The what percentage of GDP is contributed by service sector? Less than 40%, 40 to 50%, 50%, more than 50%. It was that. So it is more than 50% for sure. Number of rural illiterate. So that was a surprise again, because we didn't cover that in security market, because this was kind of out of syllabus. And there was a one question from merger. So these are the questions I remember, and the students actually told me. So once we get more questions, I'll be sharing memory based paper for you. Okay, so stay updated on bankexamstoday.com and Bank Exams Today's mobile application if you need the updated paper, the memory based paper. Thus, another surprise was there was no question from mutual fund. I mean, I did 6 lectures on mutual fund. I was really interested in mutual fund. So this is a lesson for me. If I'm interested in a particular topic, that doesn't mean I should make dozens of chapter on that particular topic. So that was a no-no for me. Commodity markets, derivatives, I did six lectures, both of these topics, but there were no questions. So that was a surprise for me. But anyways, other than that, whatever the topics are there, if you are following my course, then these topics are, familiar. You might be familiar with all these questions, except the foreign currency exchangeable bond, which I admit that we didn't cover properly. I admit that thing. So the quantitative aptitude was not that difficult at all. It was easy. The fact is that if there were 40 questions, the first 10 questions were difficult. The first 10 questions, that happened to everybody around me. I mean, I just saw all the students that told me that the first, I think, 7 to 10 questions were really difficult to everybody. Not difficult, but they were of moderate difficulty level. There were questions from miscellaneous. So anyway, student, if you are having just 20-25 minutes, if you are allotting 20 minutes or 20-25 minutes, that's a normal time that students allotted. If you have less than 1 minute, then it would be difficult to solve the miscellaneous question. One question per minute, that would be actually difficult. While the data interpretation was very easy, I would say very generic questions were there. Simple, diagram, simple, this histogram, you can say, simple diagram. Like this one, how much this thing is of this percentage, what is the how much percentage is of this, simple question. And then there was another simple, they were actually, all the sets were really easy. Then the pie charts were there, right? The simple pie chart. And interesting thing was there, simple, you pick any book of data interpretation, you will see these questions. These are total is given and the number of graduates. Percentage is given. The interesting thing is that the values were given like 20%, 30%, rest was 50%. So values were in absolute terms. So that actually made the question really easy. The missing series was very easy. I would say very easy. These were very, very easy. The approximation was very easy. Miscellaneous questions were of moderate difficulty level, I would say. So if you wasted your time in these miscellaneous questions, for example, you wasted like 10 minutes or 12 minutes and you would be able to, fetch just 6-7 marks. While if you had spent like even 10-12 minutes there, you would be able to get 20 marks with 100% accuracy. And even if you spent like 20 minutes here, I would say you could attempt 30 questions. If you spend 20 minutes on these three things, 30 questions were there with like 90% accuracy, 26, 27 marks are in your hands. But if you spend like 10 minutes here and rest of the 10 minutes another questions, then you would have at max you can get 15, 16 marks. And if be optimistic, then you can get 14, 15 marks. While if you spend like your time here, then it is more than 25. Otherwise, if you spend your time here, it is less than 20 or around 14, 15. So if same person is attempting these, it's smart work. If you are, spending more time on, if you spend more time on these three topics, then you would be scoring 25 plus. Otherwise, less than 20 or maybe less than 15. Okay. Very simple. Reasoning was, according to me, little, you would say, moderate difficulty level was there. The sitting arrangement and puzzles, they were actually easy, but there was time constraint for everybody. I mean, everybody told me that, sir, the paper was actually easy, but it was time consuming. The reasoning was time consuming. Anyways, the inequalities was very easy. I would say that was easy, easily doable, expected questions. Slog was easy. Logical reasoning was little of moderate difficulty level. Okay. Blood relations was there, one question, just one question. And then that there was a set of direction sense that was not a normal direction sense question. That was little complicated. Actually moved there and all. That was little complicated, I would say. But anyways, that was little easy to mod. I would say that was of moderate difficulty level. That was little a surprise for me. While these inequalities, Silog, very easy. Coding decoding was very easy, I would say. Out of five questions, three were easy, two were of moderate difficulty level. Inequality and Silog all were very easy. Direction sense was like little moderate but doable. Logical reasoning was, if someone has an experience of solving the logical reasoning question, then it was easy for him. Otherwise, I would say moderate. Sitting arrangement, it was easy, but there was again, I would say, it was a time consuming paper. It was not difficult, but time consuming paper. So students, that's all for today. I hope you like the analysis given by me. Now Miss Insia is going to give you the analysis of general awareness and English section. And I request all of you, if you want to join the SEBI Grade A mains classes, SEBI Grade A mains classes, we are going to start the mains classes from Monday, right? The mains classes from Monday, especially the security market. So all the section will be there. From Monday, we are going to start this course, right? Anyways, this course is actually available. The complete course is available on store.bankexamstoday.com and BankExamsToday's mobile application. You can join it anytime, right? But on Monday, we are going to start special classes. So join the special classes. That's all from me. Okay. So have a nice day.
Hi students, and welcome back to BankExamsToday.com. This video is based on the SEBI Grade A 2018 exam analysis. The exam was held on 17th of November 2018, which is today. And in this video, we are going to discuss about the questions asked in general awareness and the pattern of English questions. Okay, so we will first read the questions asked in general awareness and then what about the pattern of the questions of English. The very first question is, which country topped the human capital index? 2018, it was Singapore, and the India's rank was 115. So India's rank wasn't asked in the exam, but I mentioned here just to provide you some additional information. The second is, ease of living index topped by which state of India? It is Andhra Pradesh. The gym x exercise was held between India and which other nation? So it was very easy to identify from this J that it was held between India and Japan. And the next question is, India and Russia's bilateral summit was held in? It was held in New Delhi. So question, the options, there were different options and New Delhi was the correct one. Then Delhi signed an agreement with Russia basically with the Morse code. It was called the Twin City Agreement, and in this agreement the two cities, Delhi and Moscow, signed the memorandum of understanding that they are going to cooperate in the field of education, healthcare and sports, tourism, transport and environment for a period of 3 years. So this was, it is called Twin City Agreement, signed between India, Delhi and Moscow. Okay, and then Champions of Earth Award. We all know that our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, won the award, and there is another achievement India grabbed in this award ceremony. It was Cochin International Airport, which won the Champions of Earth Award for being the first solar powered airport. Okay, and then Moon Jae-in, who visited India recently, is the president of South Korea. Okay, then Dushanbe is the capital city of the capital city of Tajikistan, and our president visited this country recently, so therefore this question was asked. Okay, then where is Kanha Tiger Reserve located? It is located in Madhya Pradesh. Where is D.Y. Patil Stadium located? It is in Navi Mumbai. So two options were given, one was Mumbai and Maharashtra, then another one was Navi Mumbai and Maharashtra. Navi Mumbai, Maharashtra, Mumbai, Maharashtra. So maybe students were confused which one to answer. So the correct answer was Navi Mumbai. Then capital of Meghalaya, it is Shillong. So I just realized this thing that whenever there is a question on capital city, all the questions are asked from the northeastern states, because it is very difficult to memorize the capital cities of these northeastern states because they have very confusing names. So in the RBI, the question was again from the capital city of a northeastern state. So whenever you are revising the capitals and capital cities and the states, do memorize the northern states very, very carefully and remember them by heart. Then the question was based on Nobel Prize 2018 for the economics, and the correct answer is this. Now this was a very difficult question to answer because we realized that these kind of questions were not very common in the previous exams, but because India's Kirtna Pandian, she was the first girl who won this title in the IBSF World Under 16 Snooker Championship. Therefore, this question was asked because this girl won the glories for India. She brought laurels to India. Therefore, this question was asked. Then one question was from the census, that what is the literacy rate according to census 2011. Maybe I'm incorrect because there was a question from census and I'm not sure about it, but I think it was for the literacy rate. Clear? And then which state won the National Tourism Award? Again, a question was asked from the National Tourism Award 2018, but I don't know what the exact question was. Therefore, I made up this question of for the best state of for comprehensive development of tourism. It is Andhra Pradesh. This question is quite tricky. Nasik is located on which river bank? It is Godavari. So the options were, I think Mahanadi was there, Godavari and Krishna was there. So this was confusing for the students. Then Jaipur Literature Festival was organized in, it was clearly in Jaipur. This is again question which was confusing for the students. Which movie is chosen for the foreign language movie category for the Academy Award 2019? It was an Indian movie, The Village Rock Stars, made in Assamese language. So this movie was chosen for the Academy Award 2019 to be played in the foreign language category. Who owns or the which company owned PhonePe? It is Flipkart. It was easy to answer. Then the question was based on the which app is mostly used for the UPI transactions. So I got this data from a newspaper that 137 million UPI transactions were done through Paytm in September 2018. So the question was related to this, and the answer was Paytm. Then the question was, Indra Jatra is commonly celebrated in Kathmandu, Nepal. Then AIBA Women's World Championship was organized. It is going to be organized in Delhi. It just started, but the question was asked. So it was in news before it commenced. So the question was asked in the exam. Then on the 2nd of October 2018, India launched India for Humanity Initiative. And for which purpose it was launched? It was to provide rehabilitation to the physically disabled people. Global Skill Center, it is in news because India has signed an agreement with Asian Development Bank, ADB, and it is going to be located in Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Then Swachh Bharat Gramin survey was conducted by which ministry? It was conducted by Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. And the theme of International Girl Child Day, not the India's Girl Child Day or the National Girl Child Day, it was for the International Girl Child Day. So the theme was With Her, a Skilled Girl Force. November 12 is observed as World Pneumonia Day. This question was very uncommon because whenever we are studying the important days, we focus on the very obvious questions or very obvious days or the important ones. But the World Pneumonia Day is unexpected for me. Many students may agree with me. Then, who is the Indian who topped the Forbes Rich List 2018 for the 10th consecutive year? It is Mukesh Ambani. Then there is another question about this player and who he belongs to, which sports? It is weightlifting. And why he is asked by the question this asked? It is because he won India's maiden gold medal at 2018 Youth Olympic Games. So there was a question on Justice B.N. Krishna committee. I don't know, is either it was on the same committee because the question was like which committee was formed for the analysis of digital trends in the Indian economy. So I think it is the same committee, or you can correct me if there is an error. And the one question was based on the science and technology, and there was one more question on a committee. I really don't get this question clearly, so I skipped it. And one question was based on the celebration of Gandhi Jayanti, the 150th anniversary of our father of the nation. So you see, after reading all the questions, I realized that the questions were asked on the current affairs of September and October, September 2018 to October 2018. And few questions were from static GK, only like I think 6 questions were from static GK. 2 questions were based on the committee, and most of the section of general awareness was based on the current affairs of these 2 months, September and October. So if you studied the current affairs very minutely, I think that you have done very good attempt in this section. Okay, now we are moving to the English language section. When I was asking students the question about English section, they said this section took a lot of time. It was time consuming. I don't know why, but they told me that the vocab based question were of new pattern. The new pattern was like a word was given and 3 sentences were made using the same word. And the students were asked to find out the correct sentence in which the word is correctly used. Okay, there were two reading comprehension. One reading comprehension had 10 questions, the other one has had 7 questions. And the error spotting was easy. It wasn't difficult because sentences were very short. So error spotting was easy. Some students may find out for the moderate level. Then there comes the sentence completion and close test. These two are very common these days. Okay, the close test was moderate, not very difficult. But one mistake student find out is that the solutions or the options. The options were jumbled. Like if the none of the above should be placed at the bottom of the question options, but it was placed somewhere between the options. Right? And the questions were also jumbled. Like if there is a question on vocabulary, then there is a question on sentence completion, then there is a question on the reading comprehension, then again the question is based on the vocabulary or sentence completion. The questions were jumbled, the options were jumbled, but the paper the English section was moderate. I won't say difficult, it was moderate, and general awareness as well was of the moderate level. It wasn't difficult. And for the security market awareness, Raman sir will be telling you that. So I don't think about that section. I don't know about that section. So if you have any query or you have any correction for this video, you can drop your queries in the comment section. Okay. And if you are willing to go for the, if you are selected for the phase two, we have a test series as well as the notes and video lessons for phase 2 of SEBI security market awareness. Okay, so the link will be given in the description of this video lesson. You can purchase the course, watch the demo lectures, and for any query you can call on this number 9067201000. So we end this video here, and I thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.